Namaste, I'm Ekta Mehra and I'm a self-taught artist based in Seoul. I teach art to adults and kids under the brand name of Studio Bodhi, and today I will be teaching you bottle painting using acrylic paints. The first thing I'd like to tell you is the art supplies that you need to do the bottle painting. The first thing that you would be needing is a set of acrylic paints. I usually recommend using Dallara and Rowney, but you could use any other good brands available in your local art stores. I would also suggest that whatever brands you choose, you use the graduate or the professional variety and not the student variety, as these are better in terms of pigmentation and finish. Second, you would need a palette to put in your colors, a bowl of clean water, a very important part of painting, your brushes. As you can see, I have a variety of brushes, from flat brushes to pointy brushes to smaller flat brushes and to the very thin ones, which is 000. So if you're looking at numbers right from 000 to up to 4 and 5, you could have a range of brushes ready for yourself. The next thing I would like to show you is a gesso primer. This is a primer, the most commonly available primer in most of the art stores, and this is what we will need to put a base on your bottle. Along with your paints, you could also, instead of buying small tubes, if you need, you could also buy some of these big bottles of paints, depending on how you would like to use them going ahead. Lastly, for the finish of your bottle, you would need something called as a varnish. I use the gloss varnish, which is a transparent varnish, but there are different kinds of varnishes available and you could choose anything that you like which is appropriate for bottles. Lastly, and not the least, a bottle. Now, this is a wine bottle which has been cleaned and reused, but you could use any other bottles available, any other liqueur or alcohol bottle or even a milk bottle, but the only requirement is that it needs to be glass. So the first step in bottle painting is to make sure that you make your bottle ready for painting. And for that, you need to make sure that if there are any labels or stickers on these bottles, they are completely cleaned and removed and there are no glue marks or stains on the bottle. So for that, what I usually do is I soak these bottles in soap water overnight in a bucket, and that makes sure that the label and the glue gets wet. And the next morning, I simply peel it off. If it's too difficult to peel it with a hand, you could use a scrubber or a knife to make sure that the label and the glue with it is completely peeled off. Eventually, your bottle should look completely clean like this, with no labels and no stains of glue. So the first step in bottle painting is putting a base on the bottle. This is very important before you actually paint the bottle with acrylic paints, to ensure that the acrylic paints hold well on the bottle and the paints don't peel off. As mentioned, we will use the gesso primer for the base on the bottle. For that, I have removed primer in my palette and dipped it with just a bit of water. You can have a slightly thicker consistency as well. And we will use this flat brush for putting the base on the bottle. So the way you need to do it is keep your bottle straight ahead, and either you go upwards or you can go downwards. Your direction needs to be consistent for the whole bottle. And as you can see, you need to keep your brush strokes light. If you press too hard, the primer will start peeling off. Ideally, your brush needs to go one stroke from top to down. So once the primer is done, this is what your bottle should look like. It should be completely white and the bottle should be covered from all ends. Usually, you need to put at least 2 or 3 coats of primer. And after each coat, you need to wait for a few minutes to make sure that the coat is completely dry before you put the next coat. Otherwise, there is a danger of the primer peeling off. Now, after you have put the primer, usually you can start drawing. However, I usually like to put one more coat of white acrylic paint, which is this one. And this just makes sure that you have a good solid base as primer before you start painting with acrylic paint. I will be coating it using the same brush, exactly the same way in which I have coated my primer. And this is again just to give it a good solid white base. So after you have finished the white acrylic paint, this is the finish that your bottle should be having. It should look completely white and you should not be able to see the actual glass underneath it. Once we have finished doing the white acrylic paint, we can then start actually using the acrylic colors you want to use and painting the bottle. I will be using this purple pink color as my base, and the process for painting remains the same. You use again the same flat brush and you go consistently from one direction, either down upwards or up downwards, using the same brush. This is what the bottle looks like after I have finished the base acrylic paint coat on it, and I have done 3 coats of this color here, and this is what your bottle finally looks like. Now the next step in bottle painting is obviously drawing your design out. Now you have 2 options to draw the design. One is that you can actually trace your design with a tracing paper, or the other option is to actually use a simple pencil and draw your design out. As you can see, I have drawn some bit of design already, and I have used a simple pencil to draw this out. I will be sharing with you how I have done the drawing going ahead. Drawing the design using a simple pencil. As you can see, I have taken a simple pencil and any normal pencil with glue, and I'm just simply using the pencil to draw freehand whatever design I want to draw. Now you can either do the same, or you have tracing papers available in most art stores, and depending on what color you have used as your base, you can choose a lighter color tracing paper or a black or darker color tracing paper and trace your design out if you have a ready design. Next step is to actually start painting the design and the patterns we have drawn. I'm going to be using this brush, and I'm starting with a white acrylic color because I have a darker base, and I'm just again going really slowly on the pattern that I have drawn, pretty much freehand. If this is the first time you're painting using acrylic paints, my advice is to go really slow, because acrylic paints dry really fast on any surface, and hence once you have painted it, if you make mistakes, it is not easy to erase those mistakes. So my bottle is finally painted, and this is what the bottle looks like after it is completely painted. Of course, it might look different for you based on your design. Now, the last and the final step before you actually start using this bottle is to varnish it. I will be using this varnish, which is a gloss transparent varnish, and it's a liquid varnish which you need to apply using a brush. The way to do it is to use a simple flat brush, and similar to what you have been using doing for applying acrylic paint or the primer, you will simply put the varnish in your brush and with very light strokes just apply it on the bottle. Make sure you spread it out evenly so that there are no lumps forming anywhere. Now, depending on how well you apply the varnish, you may need one or two coats of the varnish, sometimes even more. And before you apply the second coat, make sure that the previous coat is fully dried up. The last thing to remember is also that varnish takes a while to dry. So once you have fully varnished and you're happy with the finish, please make sure that you do not touch the surface of the varnish of the bottle, and keep the bottle aside for a couple of days, maybe 1 or 2 days, just to make sure that it's completely dried, and then it should be ready to use. Our varnish is done and our bottle is finally ready, and this is what it looks like. You can see there's a slight glow and a shine on the bottle because of the varnish, and I would recommend using this bottle as a home decor item only and not for utility, to make sure that you're able to keep it, the paint, safe and intact on the bottle. So I hope you found this bottle painting video useful. Thank you for watching, and if you like what you see, please click the subscribe button, and also we'd love to hear your feedback on, you know, what you felt about the video, what we could change, what we could improve, and also what other tutorials would you like us to share with you. So do click the subscribe button and wait for our next video.